Good morning, Paul Georgi from Allendale. It's June 4th, Monday morning, and markets are higher here pretty much across the board in the grains this morning, and driven by weather. The weather forecast for the next 7 to 10 days looks to be dry in most of the Corn Belt. There is still some scattered showers moving across the eastern Corn Belt this morning. They will finish up, and once that system is out, it will be fairly dry across the Midwest. The positive thing is the temperatures will be cool. A lot of areas got some rain, and it'll be helpful. Talking to producers last night, they were very pleased with the way the crop looks, but still very concerned about the amount of moisture that is needed to make this crop. And that's concerning the trade here today. We've seen some good strength in corn, soybean markets this morning. And as well as the strength that we've seen in the corn markets, wheat market is also getting positive news that harvest is going to be progressing rather well here over the next several days. So that could weigh a little bit on wheat prices as we go forward. The big focus will be, however, is the USDA supply-demand report that comes out on the 12th. That will be talked about here as we move along this week. And will they reduce ending stocks in corn further, or and how they're going to adjust the soybean ending stocks are going to be two major factors that will be talked about. The export sales, however, came out on Friday. The USDA said that we should be about 7% below a year ago on exports, and as of last Friday, we're running at about 12% below. So not an exciting number there when we're looking at tighter end or potential for tighter ending stocks in this next report. Other news, the outside markets having a big influence again on commodity prices. We've got news out of China that purchaser managers index in China showed a reduction, a lower number again, which just continues to indicate that China's economy is slowing, and we're not hearing anything that they're going to do about it. So that's kind of weighing on the markets, and also was a reason for some pressure in the soybean complex here overnight. We've got Egypt talking about buying wheat out of Poland and Georgia now, which is not good for our exports. And we've also had the Commitment of Traders report from the CFTC on Friday showed that managed money reduced their long positions in corn by 47,000 plus contracts last week, and that was through Tuesday of last week, which put them at 61,493 contracts long. That's the least amount of long positions since 2010. They also increased their long positions in wheat. They added 8,449 contracts and put them up to 15,585 on long positions in wheat. Soybean contracts didn't change very much. They held about the same. There was only a 243 contract change there. Still very long in the soybean complex, and it certainly is a reason for us holding the strength that we've seen here in the bean complex. The crop conditions report out this afternoon. Trade's looking for 1 to 2% decline. That put us down around 70% good to excellent. The soybean conditions should come out this week for the first time. Trade's guessing anywhere from 65 to 70% there as the first estimate for crop conditions on soybeans. The livestock complex, of course, we're not open yet today. We would have to expect that they're going to be watching the stock market somewhat to give us an indication, at least on the opening. As last Friday, the cattle and hogs definitely bucked the trend in stock indexes because they were down sharply. Cattle and hogs ended the week on a very positive note. The Cutout values on Friday, choice down 6 cents, select down 169. We had the pork cutout values, they were up 44 cents. So look for trade there to be supported on setbacks here this morning, mainly because of market-ready supply of cattle and hogs that could support us here, and that the in the June contract of cattle especially still running behind cash cattle prices. So stay in touch with Aldo's Research. A lot of stuff going on here today. We'll keep you informed the best we can. If you got questions, you can call us at 800-262-7538. We wish everybody a very successful trading day, and I will talk to you tomorrow morning. Thank you.